OnSong can be used to play backing tracks while you perform. This can be useful when you're a one-man band and want to add accompaniment like bass or drums. OnSong can play audio files, but you can also play MIDI files for use with software synthesizers or MIDI hardware. Let's get started by linking a MIDI file to our chord chart. To do this, we tap and hold on the audio playback button in the live bar, and then tap Choose Custom Track. Since iTunes and Spotify only support audio files, we'll tap on OnSong Media Library. Let's then tap on the plus button in the upper right corner, and I'm going to choose Dropbox. Dropbox is a great way to transfer files between your computer and iOS apps like OnSong. You can sign up for 2 GB of free storage at dropbox.com. We're going to browse to our audio folder and then scroll down to pick the Music Box MIDI file that has this piano-looking icon next to it. The file is imported and added to our media library. We can then tap on it to select it. OnSong prompts if we want to update the information of the song. This will adjust the duration of the song to be the duration of the MIDI file, and it will also change the tempo if that's available. This is optional, and the backing track gets linked either way, so I'll just agree to do it. Now tap on the audio playback icon to start the track. If you're using the latest versions of OnSong, you'll hear the MIDI playback, but it might sound pretty bad. That's because the MIDI events are not being sent to a destination, which causes iOS to play the MIDI file with the built-in MIDI synth in iOS. Older versions might not play any sound. We'll discover why soon. We're going to want to change this to play where we want it so it sounds better. To do this, locate the gear icon in the menu bar and then tap to open the Utilities menu. Then choose Editors, and then MIDI. At the bottom, you'll see a wrench icon. Tap on that to open the MIDI settings menu. Now locate the playback row in the devices section. You'll see it's set to audio playback on newer versions of OnSong. On older versions, this would be set to a MIDI destination like network session, direct connection, etc. If there's nothing set up on that destination to turn the MIDI events into sound, no sound will be created. We want to change this to a synthesizer or sampler instrument so we can get a better sound. There are literally hundreds to choose from on the App Store, from companies like Korg, Yamaha, Roland, and many more. You can browse compatible apps at onsongapp.com/apps/synth. We're going to demonstrate an app by Roland called Sound Canvas. So let's go to that OnSong's app page and tap on the Roland Sound Canvas icon to be taken to the App Store. We can then buy and install Sound Canvas. What's great about the App Store is that you can get awesome sounding synths that used to cost thousands of dollars and sometimes weigh hundreds of pounds for just a few bucks. What used to fit in a box truck now fits in the palm of your hand, which is pretty amazing when you think about it. And it's delivered to your door in just a few minutes. Now that the app has downloaded and installed, we're going to open Sound Canvas. Synthesizer apps usually have a background audio mode, so our MIDI will continue to play when we leave that app and, let's say, go to OnSong. We also want to be able to turn on Virtual MIDI if it's available. So in Sound Canvas, we're going to tap on the menu button here. Then we could turn on background play. I'm also going to go to this Core MIDI setup option. And here we could turn on Virtual MIDI. Let's exit out of Sound Canvas and go back into OnSong. Now let's go back into Settings, Editors, MIDI, and then go into the MIDI Settings menu by tapping on the wrench icon, and then tap on this playback row again, and we can see the destinations that are available for playing back our MIDI. Since we turned on Virtual MIDI in Sound Canvas, we can see it right here in our list. Choose that.
Now when we tap on the audio playback button in the live bar,
we can hear that the audio sounds much better. But this song really needs to be played on a music box and not a piano. If we switch to Sound Canvas, we can see that it's playing on channel 3. But we don't want to have to switch to Sound Canvas to keep changing sounds. So let's configure OnSong to set the instrument up before we play back the song. To do this, go into OnSong, and let's pause the playback for now. Then tap and hold on the title of the song to open the section mapping menu. We can then add MIDI events that get sent when the song is loaded. We're going to tap on the plus button in the lower right corner and then add a program change on channel 3. And then set that program to 10 for music box. Tap done and close the menu. Let's tap on that section to send the MIDI since the song is already loaded. Now when we start playback, OnSong resumes playing the track where it left off, and it's done using a great sounding music box instrument instead. Of course, this is just one option. You could also send MIDI to hardware instruments using wired adapters, Bluetooth dongles, or network sessions. While OnSong can only send to one destination for MIDI playback, there are even apps that can route your MIDI for more advanced setups. We recommend contacting the manufacturer or vendor of the instrument you plan to use for more information on how to configure it using MIDI. OnSong simply can't assist with third-party apps or hardware. I hope that gives you some ideas on how you can use OnSong to play MIDI backing tracks using great-sounding synth apps or MIDI hardware. It also showed you how you can remotely configure those instruments when a song loads. There's a lot more to learn about MIDI and OnSong, so go to onsongapp.com/MIDI for more information. And as always, if you have any questions, please contact us at onsongapp.com/support. Thanks for watching.